Leonid Arkayev, the coach of the Russians team, has coached gymnasts to 82 Olympic medals, 46 gold. But he may not be headed toward another one tonight in the team finals. Nikolai Kryukov is one of his Olympic veterans. And Tim, when you talk about legendary in Russia, Arkayev is it.
Well, he certainly is. He is a gem for them. One of two coaches bestowed Coach of the Century Award. This guy has got a huge challenge right here. Nikolai Kryukov, current world champion, tore his Achilles tendon at the end of February. And somehow, after that debilitating injury, major surgery, he's able to run down and do one of the most difficult vaults in the world.
We watched him all week long in practice. On this event, every time he walked away, he would limp.
So the object of this vault, run down as fast as you can and slam your feet into the board with everything you got on an Achilles that was just fixed. It's unbelievable that he can do that vault at this stage.
And Arkayev does what he does, coaching to the end, 9-7-1-2 for Kryukov. Now, the last time we saw the United States, they were building something. Paul Hamm, Stephen McCain had good numbers on the parallel bars. Can it continue in this fifth rotation with only one more to go?
And it is critical. They've got the pumping effect going, each guy getting a bigger score. Sean has the ability to keep that party happening. Doing great so far. An event Sean really lacked a lot of rhythm on in the past. Much improved. Dismount.
Comes through.
Bang.
That's three in a row for the United States. Out of the medals by over a point. Coming into this rotation.
Beautiful back toss, sets up perfectly for the dismount, and nothing gets the judges to graciously hand out the big scores better than a stuck landing.
Sean Townsend, a 9-7-8-7. Slowly but surely, they chip away at the teams above them, Romania and Russia. Blaine Wilson.
Hopefully he can erase the memories of his last P-bar set in the first day of the team competition. They actually dropped his score.
Which is ironic, because if you were to have asked me before the games began, where can Blaine Wilson win an individual event medal, I'd have said his best shot was on parallel bars. That mistake not only hurt the team, but that means he does not qualify for individual event finals. But believe me, that is the last thing on his mind. Trickiest combination comes right here. This is where he faltered. Not today. A big set right when the USA needed it. Here's his dismount. Wow.
He is the leader and the rock of this team, but right now he's not leading. He's following the three before him by putting up another good score.
Some athletes, they need to keep in their game by just calming themselves down. Blaine Wilson is the kind of guy, when he gets mad, angry, he gets better. Believe me, he remembered what it was like to miss this element right here in day one. But he's thinking, no way on this planet is that going to happen today, and it didn't.
Sister Amy was crying in the preliminary men's qualification. Tonight, she is screaming for brother Blaine.
It's been an up and down emotional roller coaster for the American fans.
We'll crunch the numbers, but the United States is not out of the medal picture yet. The Superdome. This time, they had the belief that they could do it. And now, with an exuberance not before seen from a team of assembled Chinese gymnasts like this, China seems poised to win its first ever Olympic team gold.
And Chao Jung Feng is the last competitor, but he doesn't even need to go. They have been so dominant, this Chinese team. He just jumps up on the ring, shows the judges, I can do the strength, but that's all I need to do. We got four big ones, and that's good enough.
Coach Wang Yubin was so confident as well in floor exercise. China only sent four gymnasts to the mat. They didn't even take the chance that a fifth could give them a higher score. Now, the Russians are up against it, and that's putting it mildly. They trail Ukraine for the silver by 0.45. They only lead Japan by 0.07, wow. So they need a lot of that.
They do, and he has delivered time after time, single-handedly pulling, scratching, grabbing this Russian team.
And this isn't a surprise from Nemov. He's been doing this all day long, hitting.
Very difficult, intricate vault, 1.5 twisting laid out somersault off the horse, and then the stick.
The new dad wants to head home with a medal, 9737, but he can't do this by himself. He needs some help. He's got Alexei Bondarenko right there, who's got the talent to help this Russian team somehow salvage a medal out of this.
But he has not delivered, even remotely. Nemov knows that going into the next event, it's a tricky one for Bondarenko. He needs that guy in the game. Finally, he's got to get him in the game.
Back to Alexander Berish. We talked about the dream of a nation like Ukraine to finally be able to beat Russia. Big time stuff.
Yeah, and the scores have been escalating for this team. That's the strategy. Every gymnast up has done better than the one before.
And he's going to add to that tally. Big reputation in the sport of gymnastics. Combine that with flawless execution. That's going to compute to a big time score right here. And the Ukraine didn't even make it into the top six at the last World Championships. It devastated the team, went back home, said it would never happen again, came in here, said, we're not trying to beat China, we just know we can win a medal.
Can the United States keep this comeback thing going? This is where it's been going on for them throughout this fifth rotation. It's up to John Roethlisberger.
With this team on such a roll, that means they're in contention to win a bronze medal. Wife Kelly and mom looks on, but no one has it in their heart like this guy has been through everything and more so many times, could have given up, so many times was there saying, I gotta stand on that podium with my brethren, gotta win an Olympic team medal.
Remember, John is competing with a dislocated finger. It's swollen and it hurts.
Biggest test right here. Deals with that fine. Scores can escalate, and that's what they're looking for, but that's too bad. Not gonna happen. Right there, another break. This is too bad for the USA. They've got four great scores. It's not disastrous. But they could have eked out maybe another 10th added to that tally.
Kelly's cheering, but John's got to be disappointed. But the key thing there, and you said it, Tim, they do not have to count this score. So the United States a little bit fortunate. Maybe John realizes that. He offers up a big smile. His Olympic career is down to one more rotation.
And what happened? Does the big skill and kind of just loses a little bit of balance there, that slight adjustment, and then one more each time you do something like that, 10th of a point. And then, of course, the form here on this hop to the outside bar.
So John Roethlisberger, 9.425. Alexander Berish does a solid for Ukraine with a 9.662. And the standings will juggle again, but not at the top, where the Chinese men know they are now just four routines away. So that is not where the drama lies. No, it lies behind the Chinese. Can Ukraine hang on and prevent Russia from a medal? Can the United States come all the way back and win one?